Did you know that your Apple Mail has junk mail filtering built in? It's on by default, and when you get emails that are suspected to be junk, they have this little junk mail icon and they're turned gold. When you look at a message, another feature is that images are turned off by default, and that's because when an email has an image, it usually goes to online to get that information. And that's one of the things that spammers use to know if your email address is valid or not. But it's also what emailers use to know if you've read their newsletter or not. So when you do actually want to read the content of a newsletter, click on Load Images, and it will load the images into the email itself, as well as let the person who sent you the newsletter know that you did indeed receive it. Now, if it is a message that you really do want, you click on this button right here that says Not Junk, and from now on, any emails that come from that individual will, your computer will know that it is in fact a real genuine message. In the same way, when you have a message that you want to label as junk, when you click on it, you can come up here to your toolbar and mark it as junk, and then it will be known to be junk for the future. Now you have some further control over your junk mail. Go up to your mail menu and click on it and choose Preferences. Junk mail is the fourth icon in. And again, it's on by default. If you wanted to turn it off for some reason, you would click on that check mark. Now, when junk mail arrives, you can mark it as junk mail and leave it in your inbox. That way, all your messages will stay where they originally were delivered. Or, if you'd prefer, you can move it to a junk mailbox that's right down here. And in that way, it will gather all of your suspected junk mail into one place. You should always check it, though, because you never know when the message you want is something that you really do want. You also have some options right here. The following types of messages are exempt from junk mail filtering. If the sender of your message is in your address book, then it will not be marked as junk. Likewise, if the sender of the message is in your previous recipients, meaning you emailed them, then it will also not be marked as junk. I don't recommend having messages addressed using my full name because you never know when a spammer really does have your full name. You should also trust the junk mail headers sent by your internet service provider because companies like Comcast do have junk mail set on, and when it reaches your email program, it will be recognized. When you're done setting your preferences, close it, and there you go.